this movie specifically, I do have something.
I dare not interrupt her in the slightest because I could say a single word and she'll go on a complete tangent. I dare not.
I wanted to introduce myself. I'm Will Newman.
6 feet apart at all times. You both know the rules.
Let me guess. You're the kind of guy that ignores the rules because it makes you feel in control. Am I right?
You're not wrong.
You think that's cute?
Do you think it's cute?
When we were on set, she's incredibly talented. You're very good. And that was obviously reassuring. Better say something nice now.
No, I do really. My first impression was very nice. Then it, you know, went downhill.
Yeah, now it's after the publicity circuit. It's just.
Oh, yeah, it's like down. Okay, but it's an interesting way to see two people falling in love because they don't touch. They can't touch. They can't even get close to each other. It's so intimate because they're just being vulnerable with each other and letting each other in. They have to be naked emotionally.
I think the nature of the content we were dealing with makes it kind of impossible not to reconcile your own mortality in relation to the characters that you're playing.
The thing that I'll remember always from this movie doesn't even really have to do with the movie, as much as I enjoyed that as well and learned from that. It was hanging out with Claire Wineland, who had CF and recently passed away. It wasn't her story. Like, it's not like I was playing Claire, but the movie wouldn't have happened if it weren't for who she is and how Justin was inspired by her and then what she shared with us and her spirit in general. So meeting her, having that time with her, having her be so open with me and honest and just like hanging out with her, I couldn't have done this character without having had that time, and I'll never forget those few hours that I spent with her. That's what I'll bring with me forever.
What to you, when you read a script, stands out when it's particularly dealing with a young person?
Intelligent characters and emotionally complex characters, or not to say damaged, but I think those are the roles that interest me the most. The age doesn't matter as much. I mean, that's part of the casting process. You're going to, by your physical appearance alone, be put into certain categories during your hiring onto certain movies. But I think if the character is interesting, then it's a character that I want to pursue.
Haley, you have said before that you haven't watched Riverdale. Is that still a thing?
No, I haven't.
So you've never seen it, but what do you think Riverdale's about?
Oh, this is great.
Well, I know he plays Jughead, and people call him and Lily Bughead.
Mm-hmm.
I know that. There's the redhead guy who is the lead of the comics. And you say it's like a dark world and there's a bunch of fog. Right? And...
Yeah, they're pretty spot on. You're getting there.
Oh, I know there's the three girls that are cats. They have cat ears. Did I already say it's based off comics?
Uh-huh.
But not like superhero comics, like nerdy comics. I know you wear a hat.
All the time.
And your hair's like purple.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I do know, actually, no. I did see when it first came out some promo of Cammy and Lily wearing long socks and dancing in a gym.
Yeah, I wasn't in those long socks.
No, but they were, I mean, they're hot.
But give it another season, I'm sure.
Very attractive.
You gotta stop flirting with Lily.
I love Lily. Do you sing?
I do.
Oh no! You said you take so much pride in not letting Disney Channel make you become a singer, and now you're giving that up for a CW?
I'm broken. I'm a broken man.